The Hopcroft-Karp algorithm goes like this. We first initialize the matching to the empty set. Then we repeat the following. First, build an alternating level graph rooted at the unmatched vertices on the left part of the partition using breadth-first search. Let's pause for a moment here and see how this works in an example. The first iteration is trivial, so let's start with a later iteration where we have some existing matching marked by the orange edges here that we're trying to augment. Level 0 consists of the unmatched vertices on the left side, and to go to the next level, we follow the unmatched edges. Then we follow matched edges to get back to the left-hand side. And then we follow along unmatched vertices, which lead us to an unmatched vertex on the right-hand side. So that's a level we can stop at. And we end up with this here for our total level graph. Having built this level graph, we use it to augment the current matching with a maximal set of vertex disjoint shortest augmenting paths. We accomplish this by starting at one of the unmatched vertices in R and tracing our way back. Let's say that I use this path here. Well then, because I'm looking for a set of vertex disjoint paths, I can go ahead and delete these vertices. And with these vertices deleted, I can also go and delete all the other vertices that got orphaned in the process. And at this point, we note that I had to delete the other unmatched vertex in R, and that tells me that I found a maximal set of vertex disjoint shortest length paths. Once we've applied all these augmenting paths, we go back and rebuild the level graph, and keep doing this until no more augmenting paths exist, and then we can return the matching that we found. From the description, it's clear that each iteration of this loop, what we'll call a phase from now on, takes only order e time. Building the level graph is done by breadth first search, and so that only takes order e time. And the second part can also be thought of as a single traversal of the graph, essentially. As we're picking a path from one of the unmatched vertices in R to one of the unmatched in L, we can follow any edge here. We don't have to be careful at all, because in effect all roads lead to an unmatched vertex in L. The key insight is that only about the square root of V phases are needed in order for us to get to a point where there are no more augmenting paths. Overall then, we seek to prove the theorem stating that given a bipartite graph, the Hopcroft-Karp algorithm finds a maximum matching in time order E times the square root of V.